Hello everyone, it's Shane Kanto, your Wasteland reviewer, and I'm here to review Apple TV Plus's new film, Coda. And this is from writer-director C.N. Heater, who, looking into her work, realizing that she directed episodes and wrote episodes of Little America, and Glow, and Orange is the New Black, and I'm like, okay, there's some talent here. Glow's great. One of my favorite shows on Netflix. But Little America, I thought was really special and was very heartwarming. And you get that feel in this film. And what's interesting about this film is this was huge at the festivals and got picked up by Apple and bought for a lot of money. This, I'm pretty sure, beat Palm Springs' record from last summer on the amount of money spent to buy up distribution rights for a festival film. And CODA, standing for Child of Deaf Adults, is a really, really moving film. And this is about Ruby, who is the hearing daughter of two deaf parents who has an older deaf brother as well. So she's the only one that can hear out of this family, and that causes a lot of interesting dynamics. And the most interesting thing about her journey is that she wants to be a singer, which then her family can't really appreciate or really understand because they can't hear her. And going back to Heater real quick, the direction of this is very well done. It's well crafted. There isn't anything like, I'm also going to be reviewing The Green Knight. There's nothing like that in this film. It's just competently directed, well-paced, and just, this feels like a well-put-together, warm film. And that really works in its favor because there's a lot of emotions going on in this film. My biggest drawback of this film is the plots. The narrative is pretty standard and straightforward, and you know the beats that are going to be coming throughout the film. But if you have a film that can hit you so emotionally that you could get past being like, well, I know exactly what's going to happen next, that's something special. Coda does that. There's so many scenes in this film. Like, I was watching this and my fiance walked downstairs and she was like, are you okay? Because I was like sitting in the chair and like looked upset. And I'm like, no, I'm just watching the movie. It's making me feel some things. And there's such an interesting dynamic in this film. To paint a picture, you have Ruby, who's much more low-key. She feels pressured and pressed by her family to keep helping with their fishing business because they need her to translate and they really rely upon her. And it causes some tensions with her brother, who feels like she's the golden child and he's a baby because he can't hear, so they don't trust him with things, but he's trying to read lips. And then you have the parents, the mother, who is not very trusting of hearing people and is very defensive about that. And then you have the father who, like, really does rely upon his daughter and is a very funny and vulgar man. And the mother and father are so horny for each other, which causes some of the funniest scenes in the film. And they do rely upon Ruby so much. And, like, at a doctor's appointment, when dad's getting really graphic about stuff going on down there, it's really awkward for a daughter to have to explain that to a doctor. And you have that, but you also have this overzealous, kind of a jerk music teacher who really wants to help Ruby. And then she's paired up with this young man in class. And they have their issues. He's trying to understand her. They have that tension. There's a lot of dramatic potential here. And Heater does such an amazing job of capitalizing on basically all of it. There's so many great scenes. There's an amazing scene between the mother and daughter trying to process their relationship. There's an amazing sequence of her performing towards the end of the film and what helping her family process how much this means to her. And then an even more amazing moment between father and daughter afterwards. And the writing is so well done because it's able to balance all these different things, craft all this different drama, and really deliver on all of it. I was invested, even in the smallest subplots of, like, Ruby's best friend who named Gertie, who really is into her brother, and she's like, what's the sign for, I think you're really hot. And then, you know, Ruby doesn't give her those signs, gives her something else, and she embarrasses herself a bit. But there's so many great moments in this film of human interaction. And besides Heater's great work on the film, this cast is amazing. You have Amelia Jones, who plays Ruby, and this is really a big star-making role for her. Apparently, she was in the film High Rise. Strange film, not a huge fan of it, but, you know, she's really talented in this. She was in Lock and Key. She does such a great job of feeling that frustration and getting that across. And she's a low-key person. She doesn't want this attention. She doesn't want this pressure. And you feel that. It's genuine. Then you have the amazing Marley Matlin, who plays the mother, acclaimed actress who in real life is deaf, along with the actors who play the husband and son as well. She got so much acclaim for, Children of a Lesser God. And this, she is so great. The scene that she has with Jones, where they're having this mother-daughter situation, resolving in this conversation the subtlety and the little things that Matlin brings to it. And that Troy Kotsur, who plays the dad, Frank, is hilarious. But he has an amazing scene, along with Jones later in the film. And everybody has these big emotional moments. And Daniel Durant, who plays the brother. And then a little quick shout out to like Amy Forsyth, who plays Gertie, the best friend. Ferdia Walsh Pilo, who from Sing Street, plays this guy from class. And boy, does he still look Irish, even trying to be this American kid. And then shout out to Eugenio Derbez, who's Bernardo Villalobos. Don't even try to say his name if you can't roll the R. Don't embarrass yourself. Just call him Mr. V. So he has that kind of personality. And this was a role perfect for him. And he really capitalizes on it. Acting's great. I love the characters, their drama together. Even if the narrative's a little tropey and you know where this is going, it's such an enjoyable and heartwarming and emotional coming-of-age story. Heater knocks it out of the park with this film, and I can't wait to see what she does next. So go check this out on Apple TV+. But those are my thoughts on Coda. Let me know what you think, and let's talk some movies. But thank you, as always, for tuning in and supporting your Wasteland Reviewer.